Good morning, Steve Whiteside here with your daily market outlook for Thursday, April 28th, 2011. In the pre-market this morning, coming up to 6:30 a.m. on the East Coast, we've got stock index futures basically flat. They're slightly above the zero line, but definitely no fall through to the upside. We do have some economic numbers coming out before the open this morning, so we'll have to wait and see if those affect the futures. Commodities, well, gold and silver up once again. Crude oil is up slightly in the pre-market on Thursday morning. Well, yesterday was the big Fed meeting, and the ramifications of the meeting is that nothing changed. As far as we're concerned, I think we only had one significant trend change last night, but otherwise everything else held the same. We're coming into the end of month bias, and it's the end of April, of course, and we've got money flowing in automatically into the market. So even if the market wanted to go down right now, we wouldn't see a significant sell-off between now and early next week. Let's start out taking a look at the 60-minute charts for Thursday's trading activity. We had a big reversal day yesterday for the TSX. It drove lower, it tried to fill the open gap, couldn't do it, and reversed right back. Unfortunately, we couldn't gain any traction and ended back in the flypaper channel. So while we had a reversal, it is kind of muted since we couldn't make any additional headway, and we're stuck in no man's land, so neither the bulls or the bears are in control right now. We're waiting for some catalyst to either take us higher, and again, our first target is 14,062. Of course, you can see the target above that, but I hate mapping out all those targets because we're still dealing with the first target. And to the downside, we never filled the open gap yesterday, so we still have a target of 13,750 if the market wants to move lower. Now, we ended the day on Wednesday on an hourly buy signal, and so that would only change if we start closing below 13,841. Now, when we look at the hourly flypaper channels for the major indexes that we follow on the TSX, such as gold, materials, energy, and financial services, they all ended stuck in the flypaper channel. So Wednesday turned out to be a very neutral day with no new guidance points that we can use to figure out where we're going next. Moving over, looking at the daily charts, it's a matter of really no changes from Wednesday. The VIX is still in a downtrend. The U.S. dollar is still in a downtrend. It's moving lower this morning. Canadian dollar is still in an uptrend. It's moving higher this morning. No change for bonds, and I'd be concerned if the bonds had have come back into the channel yesterday, but they didn't. No change for gold, and it's moving higher this morning. No change for silver. It's moving higher this morning. Copper did move down and generated a sell signal on Wednesday, so that is one trend change that we saw. No change for coal, no change for crude oil, no change for natural gas. Kind of concerned about natural gas, can't seem to break out above the previous highs. It did make a higher low in the past month, and that's bullish, but we need to see it make a higher high. Take a look at uranium, no change here, we're still on a sell signal. No change for the TSX, no change for energy stocks, still we're looking for a breakout, no change for financial services, no change for gold stocks. Came back into the channel, but no new major upward pressure on gold stocks. No change for silver stocks. We did see a couple of them turn around off their recent sell signals, but no change for the overall index. No change for materials. No change for copper stocks. They traded back into the channel. No change for the fertilizer index. I believe potash in Canada is now on a daily sell signal, so a little weakness there. Uranium stocks, the index actually closed above the upper channel line. That is not totally representative of the whole index. We had a couple of the major U.S. Stocks move higher yesterday, and that put upward pressure on the index. But for most of the Canadian stocks, they're still on sell signals, or if they're on buy signals, they really didn't move that much yesterday. No change for the Venture Exchange, no change for the Venture 30. So Yesterday, big day. Bernanke came out, spoke to the media. That's a first. But really, I guess the reason that he was able to do that was he knew that nothing he would say would affect the market on a short-term basis. Still looking at the U.S. markets hitting new highs yesterday, and I think at some point, probably next week, we'll start to turn around and start moving lower. We're extremely overbought right now, and I don't think there's the volume and the enthusiasm to push the market much higher. So we'll have to see how that affects the Canadian market. But right now, no major changes from Wednesday that we need to take action on Thursday morning. Okay, thank you very much for your time, folks. Have a great day, and we'll talk to you again on Friday morning.